let me ask you, are you overflowing? Well, you might reply, what do you mean, am I overflowing? Well, you should be overflowing, and maybe it's just the fact that we have a perception problem. And in today's Revisited Devotional, Dr. Brad Winninger is going to explain to us using the song Count Your Blessings. Stay tuned for that. My name is Tyler Candy, and I am the Media Director here at Central Baptist Church, and you are watching a Revisited From the Shepherd to the Sheep Daily Devotional. And I thank you for that. I want to welcome you to this video, but also to all the content that we produce and share on this platform. And you might be watching us on YouTube or Facebook or Instagram, and I thank you for that. If you would, go ahead and like this video, subscribe to us, and then share this out with your friends and your family. What this will do is allow us to be able to reach so many more people with the gospel and with encouragement on how to walk your Christian walk for Christ. And you would be doing us a great service, and we appreciate that. If you need some help, you can head over to our website at cbcwoodbridge.org. That's cbcwoodbridge.org. And at the top, you'll find a media tab with links to all of our social platforms, including YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And if you can just subscribe to us there, but then also share that out with your friends and your family, that'll be great. Let's head over to Dr. Brad Winninger as he explains to us how we can be overflowing by counting our blessings.
When upon life's pillows you are tempest tossed, when you are discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord hath done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God hath done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God hath done. Count your many blessings, see what God hath done. In Proverbs chapter 28 and verse number 20. Proverbs 28 and verse 20, it says, a faithful man shall abound with blessings. The word abound in the Bible, related to abundant, means overflow or overflowing with. So overflowing with blessings. Now our problem is one of perception. When we have a problem, it seems like any problem is huge. And when we are blessed, we tend to minimize or the problems that seem to balance it out tend to diminish the amount of blessing that we experience. This is something we need to work on. It's the flesh at work. And so we need to do something about it. We need to meet the flesh with the truth and by the power of the Spirit. And when we are blessed, we need to verbalize it. We need to say, I am truly blessed. I am so blessed. We should be praising the Lord. And we should be acknowledging the Lord, and we should be sharing with everybody. So make this a rule of thumb today and every day. Think about the many blessings. Count them up, write them down, record them, journal it, and then tell several people. Make it a point every single day to tell several people how blessed you are. You know, I am just so blessed. I have been so blessed. With the opportunities, with the job, with the health, with the living that we experience, we are so blessed. Most importantly, I have Jesus Christ as my Savior, and I know that I'm on my way to heaven. I was reading in the Bible the other day, and it tells us that we're all sinners and we've come short of the glory of God, but we can have eternal life through Jesus Christ. Isn't that great? So share your blessings every single day. Count your blessings, number them, write them down. After you begin, you're going to find that there are many more than you're able to actually record or remember. But let's just start out with making a list and sharing it with others, telling people, using that as an open door of opportunity to witness to people and to tell them about Jesus Christ, because we are so very blessed. Count your many blessings. And if we need to today, we need to confess our ungratefulness, our unthankfulness. What a surprise blessing it is just to think about all the things that God is doing for us right now. Father, I thank you for salvation. Thank you for my life. Thank you for my opportunity to serve you. Thank you for my family. Thank you for the good things in my life. Thank you for America. I pray that you'll help me today to express that to many others. With our head bowed and our eyes closed, if you've never received Christ as Savior, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Would you pray right now from your heart to God and say, Lord Jesus, come in my heart, save me right now, take me to heaven when I die. And He will. Please share that with us. And if you're winning souls, please share that as well. And right now, let's pray. Lord, we pray for those who are sick, that are less fortunate, those that have less, those that are under the weight or the burden of some problem. Lord, I pray that you'll lift that burden, that problem off of them. And thank you so much in Jesus' name. Amen. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God hath done. I'm serious, make a list of your blessings and begin to share them today. God bless you.
You are listening to From the Shepherd to the Sheep Daily Devotionals. This is a ministry of Central Baptist Church in Woodbridge, Virginia. If you would like to learn more about our ministries, you can find us online at cbcwoodbridge.org. You will also find many other helpful resources there, including preaching, devotionals, and songs. We thank you for listening to this devotional, From the Shepherd to the Sheep.